In this video, we will demonstrate one way of analyzing some typical ELISA data using GraphPad Prism. I have been using Prism for a few years now, and it does a very good job of simplifying data analysis. If you have never used Prism before, I would definitely encourage you to try it. You can test it out with a free 30-day trial by clicking the link below or in the video description. In the last video, we demonstrated how to organize our data in Excel such that it will be easy to copy into Prism for analysis. Prism does have tools of its own that can be used to manipulate your raw data, but my personal preference is to have the data in the following format before bringing it into Prism. So for typical ELISA data, you'll want to have three columns. The first column will contain the known concentration of the standards. The units and the value of those concentrations is going to depend completely on how you prepared your standard curve. The second two columns are going to contain the absorbance measurements of your standard curves. So here's the first standard curve, and here's the second standard curve, and you can see they all have corresponding concentrations. Our two blank measurements have a concentration of 0. And below our standards are the absorbance measurements of our samples. Because I measured my samples in duplicates, the duplicate measurements are side by side one another. So for example, this would be sample 1's measurements, and this is sample 2's measurements, sample 3, and so forth. If my samples were measured without duplicates, then I would only have one column with one absorbance measurement per sample. And if I measured the samples in triplicate, then I would have three columns, one column for each measurement of that particular sample. Whatever the case may be, the concentration column for your samples must always be empty, because the whole point of doing the ELISA is to calculate the concentration, which we don't know yet. Now we're going to copy the data and paste it into Prism. For those of you who are new to Prism, the first thing that we must do is select our desired type of table and graph. You can see to the left that Prism has a number of different tables and graph types to choose from, and choosing the correct table type to match the data you have to analyze is essential. For our standard curve data, we're going to use an XY table. As for the other options that we have here, your selection should be based on the maximum number of absorbance measurements that you have for your standards and samples. So we're going to choose to enter two replicate values in side-by-side columns because, as I mentioned earlier, we have duplicate measurements of our samples and standards. If we had three standard curves or we made triplicate measurements, then we'd want to increase the replicates here to 3. But since we only have 2, we're going to select 2 and hit Create. You can see on the left that we now have an empty data table called Data1 and a graph which is also called Data1. In Prism, the data tables and the graphs are linked to one another, so any changes that we make in this table will automatically be reflected in this graph. You can see here that the graph is empty because we haven't put any data into our table yet. Now we will paste our standard curve data into the table. So now you can see that I have my concentration here with the title in the correct place. And here's my absorbance title and the absorbance measurements of my standards next to the standard concentration. All the absorbance measurements of my samples are below our standards, which is the correct place for them to be too. So let's take a look at our graph. Prism is asking us here to choose how we want our graph to look. We are going to select the plot with no connecting lines because connecting lines would obscure the curve that we're going to fit to our data in the next step. You can see now that the standard curve data is here on our graph. Also notice that the labels that we added to our data table are automatically added to the graph as axis titles. Let's zoom in so we can see a little bit better. So notice under the analysis panel that we have a button here called Interpolate a Standard Curve. The dialog box that opens gives us a number of choices, and each one may be appropriate depending on the shape of the standard curve data. If you click on one of the choices, the Details button appears, and clicking on that reveals the shape of the curve that will be fit using that selection, as well as some advanced options and settings, which we will not get into for the sake of time. But information about all of these can be found in the Help menu. So back to the curve selection, I've found that a second order polynomial is a good choice for most typical ELISA standard curve data, but you'll always have to check how the curve fits and select a different type of curve depending on how your data might be. As for the options, I'm going to leave the outliers handling set to no special handling, and I'm going to check the report each interpolated value, but I'm not going to select any of the confidence intervals. That's an optional feature. And I'm also going to select to plot the curve with a 95% confidence band. That way we can examine how well the curve actually fits our data. So now I'm going to hit OK. So you can see to the left here that Prism has created a new page in the results folder, which is labeled Interpolation of Data 1. This has a set of subpages, which include the interpolated mean values and also the interpolated replicates. Here's a table of some results, which includes statistics, which might be interesting for us to determine whether the curve actually fit our data well. So one of the ways I like to check and see if this curve fit our data well is to go to the graph itself. So at a first glance, we can see that the trend fits the higher concentrations in our standard curve quite nicely, but it's a little bit difficult to see what's going on down here with the lower concentrations. So first, let's duplicate this graph so we can change the axes a little bit. I'm going to right-click and click on Duplicate the Current Sheet, and now I have two identical graphs. And on this one, I'm going to double-click on one of the axes, and I'm simply going to uncheck the automatic determination of range and interval option, and I'm going to change the axes as follows. I'm going to make the minimum 0, and I'm going to divide the maximum of our axis by 4 to make it 0.5. That's for the y-axis. There's a tab here for the x-axis. Uncheck the automatic range and interval. And I'm going to divide the maximum here by 4 as well, just so that way we can zoom in on the lower quadrant of our graph. So now that we've zoomed in on this lower quadrant, we can see pretty clearly that our interpolated curve fits the data quite nicely. So having seen that, we can feel that this interpolated curve represents our standards, and we can use this to interpolate the concentration of our samples. So now let's take a look at our interpolated x values. So if you look here, these are the average of the absorbance measurements of our samples. And you can see that some of our samples had negative absorbances, and that's because they happened to have an absorbance which was just a little bit lower than the blank itself. So what that tells us is that the concentration of these samples we can assume is 0, or at least it was below the range of our ELISA. So here we would just put a 0. These are the interpolated concentrations of our samples. You can see that this sample number 5 had a concentration of about 1.5 nanograms per milliliter. These samples had a concentration of around 75. So one thing to keep in mind is that if you diluted your samples before you added them to the ELISA plate for analysis, then you're going to need to multiply those concentrations that we've calculated here by whatever the dilution factor was. So for example, if you diluted your samples tenfold before you measured them in the ELISA, then the actual concentration of those samples is going to be 10 times higher than what you see here. So there you have it. You now have determined the concentration of your unknown samples by interpolating your standard curve data with Prism. The next step will be for you to organize your data appropriately, graph it, and do statistical analysis on it for your next paper or presentation. If this tutorial was helpful, please click the like button below and share it with others. You can also subscribe to our channel for updates when new videos are released. Thanks for watching.